Hello and welcome back to this third installation of our guide to modding Europa Universalis IV for beginners. My name is Alex or Midgeman and I am one of your community ambassadors, and I, along with the fantastic modding community, will be your guide for this course. In today's video, we are going to be discussing modding a custom event. In this tutorial, we will discuss key terminology, such as effects, modifiers, triggers, and scopes, as well as the general game state and how it relates back to your code. We will create a custom event, we will cover creating a country modifier, and we will cover creating custom localization. First, let us discuss some key aspects and terminology that will help you understand how scripting in EU4 works. If you are playing the game at any given moment, your game is constantly changing due to events, missions, decisions, and national ideas, for example. This is abstractly known as the game state, or quite literally, the state of your game. It isn't actually anything in the code, but it is in fact the end result of all of your scripting from your code. It is imperative that you understand some key terms, as we're going to be using them a lot here. Here are all of the aspects that affect the game state. First and foremost, triggers. Triggers are a check for if certain information in the game is true. For example, if you wanted to check that a country is Catholic, or that a province had a certain owner, or check that a global flag was set, this would be done with a trigger that checks information is actually true. These are then used to implement our second term, that would be effects. Effects are things that immediately change the game state. For example, if you want to change how much money is in your treasury, or you want to add 3 stability to your nation, or you want to kill off a ruler, or you want to fire an event, you need to do these things through an effect. Our third term to understand is scopes. Whereas triggers are for checking information and effects are for applying the changes, scopes are the identifiable features within the code. A scope can be a province, a country, or a region, and so much more. And finally on our list of terms, modifiers. Modifiers are things that constantly change the game state. For example, a modifier of +5% discipline will constantly change a country's discipline stat to have an increase of 5%. Whereas previously, those effects that we placed might be temporary. Another example of a modifier would be +2 local unrest, which will constantly increase a province unrest level by 2, thus affecting the game state. Our goal today is to create an event that will use a country scope to check a trigger. That trigger will be for the country to have the tag MFM, which is the country we have been making in the previous episodes of this guide. But we will also include additional triggers of having less than 3 stability. After that, we will make the event give 2 options, one of which will apply an effect of +1 stability, and another which will apply a modifier of +1 monthly prestige, thereby using and showcasing all of the key terminology that we've just discussed that affect game state modification. Creating an event frame. In our mod directory, create a folder called events. Then create a text file called myfirstmod_events. This is where we're going to write out our event for the mod. When we open it up, the first thing we need to do is to create a namespace for our event. A namespace is a way for the game to identify your events and not get them confused with other events both in your mod and in the base game. Our namespace will be myfirstmod_events. Now, we want our event to be in a country scope, so we're going to make it a country_event. If we wanted our event to be a province scope affecting a single province as opposed to the whole country, we would write province_event here. Next, we need to assign our event an ID. To do that, we type ID equals. Our ID should be the same as our namespace, followed by a dot and then a set of numbers from 1 to 9999. In our case, we're going to make our ID myfirstmod_events.1. Next, we need to add a title, which we're going to call myfirstmod_events.1.t. And for the description, we're going to call it myfirstmod_events.1.d. Both of these are localization keys, which we'll get to later. Next, you can find an event image. Images require a specific GFX name in order to load them properly. You can find a list of them online in the EU4 mod wiki, where they not only list out all of the different pictures, but also a list of different names used in coding. All you would have to do is grab one of those codes and paste it next to the picture line to give your event an image that might be more fitting. For our sake, I'm going to use the event picture for an angry mob. So I'm going to type in all caps, angry underscore mob underscore lowercase event picture, with the P being capitalized. The trigger. We need to create a trigger for our event. Since we're in a country scope, we are checking if any country in the game has the following true information, and if that is the case, the game will allow the event to happen. We're going to write trigger equals curly brackets. Then we're going to add a trigger to check if the country is my first mod, or MFM. To do that, we simply type tag equals MFM within those brackets. It's that simple, but triggers can be much more in-depth. You can see a full list of triggers on the EU4 wiki, which lists out the different triggers, what they exactly check for, and what scopes to use them in. Now, we need to discuss the use of not equals brackets in the triggers. Normally, triggers check if the information is true, or in the case of checking for an integer, they check if the number is greater or equal to it. Our trigger checks if we are the tag MFM, and will only work if we are that tag. If you wanted to check if our country had one stability, you would write stability equals one, and it would return as true if the country had one stability, two stability, or three stability. Not equals brackets inverts the current trigger, checking that the information is either not true or less than the listed amount. If you wanted to check that a tag was not Sweden, you would write not equals bracket tag equals Sweden, or SWE. Since we want the event to check that the country has less than three stability, we would want to have not equals open curly bracket stability equals three close curly bracket. With that, our triggers are set. Mean time to happen. Next, we need to define how long it will take for this event to happen. We're going to use a mean time to happen. Mean time to happen essentially states how frequently this event will fire. If the mean time to happen is 3 months, then on average, every 3 months, it will happen. It does not mean it will happen exactly in 3 months, and it can happen in 3 days, it can happen in 3 years, even if it is very unlikely to do so. Let's set our mean time to happen to be 10 days. We do this by typing the following. Mean underscore time underscore two underscore happen equals curly bracket days equals 10, close curly brackets. We can set the mean time to happen in months or days. We can also change the likelihood of the event happening through the use of a modifier, which is activated if another trigger is true. Let's say you wanted our event to be more likely to happen because my first mod has at least one stability. To do this, we type in modifier equals open curly bracket and the factor equals 0.5 close bracket. And we insert this inside the mean time to happen. The number to the right of factor is just the amount by which the original mean time to happen will be multiplied by. So in this case, let's make it 0.5, halving its mean time to happen. We still need a trigger here, so let's add an additional line to add the trigger stability equals 1. Now our event will fire should a country match the triggers. However, this is not the only way an event can fire. Is underscore triggered underscore only can make the event fire only when it is told to be by an effect, such as in a mission effect or in another event. An event with is triggered only will never fire on its own. So if you want an event to fire after the player enacts a decision or in some other specific circumstance, then adding that line in there would be quite useful. There is also more that we can add in this section to help get the desired result with our code. Fire only once will make the event fire only one time in the entire game. So even if another country suddenly meets the trigger, it will not fire. If you want an event to fire and then not happen again, use this. Otherwise, it will happen over and over until the trigger is not true. We're going to put this in our code. So we are going to just type fire underscore only underscore once equals yes in a new line in the event. Number two, hidden equals yes. This will make the event hidden, meaning the player and the AI cannot interact with the event. This can be useful if you want an event to change something in the background without the player even noticing. However, we want the player to see our event, so for us, we're not going to use this. Immediate equals allows for the instant application of an effect, before the player even gets a chance to pick an option. This is useful if you want the player to have to deal with it, for example rebel uprisings or disasters, without them holding or stalling the event. Note, when you use the immediate command, the effects will appear in the description of the event. If you want to hide this, place all of your effect code inside of a hidden underscore effect scope, which, as the name implies, will make them hidden to the player. Options. Now we move on to adding an effect. We do this by adding an option, which will give us different options to click on in the event panel. Every event needs one to function, or they'll just never clear the screen. There are many different things you can put in an option. You can put most effects there, and if you want to see a full list of effects, you can go to the Paradox Wiki and go to the effects page. These effects will go into place after you select the option. There are other options beyond just putting in an effect. Here are some of the things you can include. A highlight, which you can include by typing highlight equals yes, which will change the color of the option to a bright green. This can be good if you want to alert the player to the importance of the option. A trigger, which can enable or disable certain options. This is done by simply adding a trigger equals line into the option and then adding a trigger. If you want the option to only be visible to countries with Swedish culture, then you can include that here. You can include AI chance, which checks for which option the AI is more likely to choose. You can do this by putting AI underscore chance equals factor equals X, where the X is how likely they are to pick the option. This can be modified further by triggers. So, we're going to make our first option like so. Next, we want to name our option. The general format for giving names to your option is taking the event ID and then adding a period and a letter. So, for us, this will be my first mod underscore events dot one dot A. Option name equals my first mod, like so. Inside the option, you can add any effects you wish. For us, we want to make our event add one stability. So all we have to write is the effect for that, which is add underscore stability equals one. Next, we want to add our second option. We're going to name this one my first mod underscore events dot one dot B. Event modifiers. Here, our goal is to make an event that gives us a modifier. Before we can set that modifier, let's go about actually creating one. Go to your common folder in the mod directory and create a folder called events underscore modifiers. Next, create a new file called myfirstmod underscore modifiers.txt. By opening it up, we are going to first define our modifier. For that, we need to make a name for it, ours being myfirstmod underscore modifier equals. Inside this, we're going to put our modifiers. We wanted the option to give us plus one yearly prestige. So here, I'm going to put prestige equals one. And just like that, we have our modifier created. If you want a complete list of all modifiers, you can go to the EU4 wiki and look through their organized and clearly defined list of all the different types of bonuses you can give to a country or province through a modifier. Going back to our event, however, in our second option, we're going to put in the effect to define a modifier. Since we want this modifier to affect our country, not a province, we're going to add a country underscore modifier and then use the name of the modifier we defined in the file. That will look like the following. We need to add a number on the other side of duration. Duration is how long this modifier will last for. The duration is measured in days. So if we were to put 365, the modifier will last for a full year. If we were to put 3,650, it will last 10 years. If we put negative 1, it will be a permanent modifier and never go away. We will put negative 1 here, as we want the modifier to last until the end of the game. Now, with that done, we have our event, and it's ready to go code-wise, but it has one small part that still needs adjusting. Localization. Going into our localization file from the last episode of the series, we have several things that we need to add. Specifically, an event title, an event description, an event name for option 1, an event name for option 2, a name for our modifier, and a description for our modifier. The event title, event description, and event options will be taken directly from our event. We take the titles that we generated earlier, and we write down their information. Next, we're going to make our title here My First Event. The description will be Hello World, and the first name will be Give Me an Effect. The second name will be Give Me a Modifier. Finally, we need to localize our modifier. To do that, we get the name of our modifier, my first mod underscore modifier, and in quotations, put my first modifier. Modifiers can also include descriptions. To write those, on a new line, write DSC underscore my first mod underscore modifier, and write, this is my first modifier. Now, with all the localization out of the way, when we launch up the game and click our country, sure enough, we wait a few days and our event will fire. We can clearly see option one giving us plus one stability, while option two will give us a permanent modifier. Resources. The event we just made was relatively simple. There can be incredibly complex events that only fire in certain specific instances, while others can have varying effects that take into account the user's personal situation as well. A common tactic for modders is to retool existing events for different use cases. Here are a few events that have unique triggers and effects that could give inspiration and help you if you wish to better understand modding. Number one, wedge throw slash payback, Buddhism underscore events 10/11. This event gives the player the option to pay money to improve a specific province. And then the next event, it gives the player a reward. It uses province flags and province modifiers to check that this is occurring. And as such, is a useful event to see how exactly how cause and effect events could work. Number two, the Rise of the Chosokabe, flavor underscore daimyo dot one. This event gives the player the option to spawn a tag as a vassal in their country, which could be useful to a modder who wants an event where a nation emerges from another and becomes a vassal, because simply releasing a country is not all that required. Number three, National Bank, 40/20. This event spawns a national bank. Whilst the trigger and effect are quite basic, the mean time to happen has several different modifiers on it that are being checked that can slow down the rate of firing or speed it up. If you want to get a better grasp on how to develop complex mean time to happen code, this could be a good event to look at. And finally, the Persian Embassy, flavor underscore Zan dot 8, flavor underscore Zan dot 11. This event chain is all about Kilwa establishing an embassy in a Persian province. This is a good event to look at when you want to see a back and forth between different nations, with events for rejection and acceptance. If you want to create an event where there's back and forth between nations, this one is very useful. All of the events use a variety of triggers, scopes, and effects. For a detailed list on all potential triggers, the EU4 wiki has a list of all the triggers, along with their scopes and how to use them. The same is true for effects, in which it also lists the scopes and potential notes and modifiers, which include some rarely seen modifiers in game. As such, we highly recommend giving it a look through for potential inspiration and to double check the correct usage. Thank you so much for watching yet another part to this modding guide. Please remember to leave a like and join us in the next video, in which we will be breaking down creating cultures and religions. Let us know in the comments down below what events you created for your mod, and we'll see you next time.